What's up, lads? Today I'm going to teach you math. Okay. 2.1. Got the webcam attached to my head. Whatever I see, you see. 2.1. 12% simple interest per year. How much interest will be owed on a loan of $500 at the end of 2 years? Is your I 0.12? P is equal to 500 dollars. F is equal to ? And your T will be 2 years. So here's your equation. F equals P times 1 plus I to the N. So we have P being $500. It's good to put the dollar sign as a unit so you know what you're working with. This textbook is good. It throws like, Japanese currency, it throws euros, it keeps changing the currency, it keeps it fresh, so you learn all the symbols while you learn economics. Let's do one thing here. Playing some RuneScape right now. I'm ranked 2, not much shit, so I'm just AFK, chopping wood, anyways. Got the video game music in the background, it's good shit, man, it's good shit. We got, okay, 1.12 squared. So that's 100. I think, because 12 squared equals 144, so 1.12 squared would be, what, 1.144, because it's after the decimal, so you just pretty much multiply this by itself, and the 1 carries through. Is that how it works? Let's check Google. My calculator broke. Yeah, my calculator broke, so I'm going to go to Google. I'm going to type in 500 times 1.12 squared. Yeah. What we get, F is equal to 627.20. So that's if you invest 500 bucks, 12% per year for 2 years. You'll have $627.20. That's pretty good. 2.2. Principal and interest at the end of 6 months. So when it says it wants the interest equals future minus present. So you're gonna owe more and you're gonna receive more. So if you're getting lent money, you'll pay the interest. So it's a deficit. But if you're lending someone else money, then you get the interest. So the interest equals the F minus P, which is the future value minus present value. Now it's saying the simple interest rate's 9%, so that's 9% per year, and it wants to do just 6 months of this, so for a 6 month period, the T will be, I think either T will equal 0.5, and I will equal 0.09, or you can do T equals 1. And I equals 0.045. But this is changing the compounding rate, so I think it's actually this. So this is probably, if they're equivalent, I don't think they're equivalent, but I think this is the correct one. So let's do it might not even work though. So the future will equal, put the music back on. Okay, we're back. Okay, 3,000 pounds times 1.09, because it's 1 plus I, like up here, to the 0.5, which is going to give us like a low value. Oh, it'll still give us a value above 1, so we'll go up still. Anything that's above 1, even if you do like infinitely small roots, you'll never go below 1. So there's still like, it's making sense so far. This seems to be the right way to do it. So what do you get from this? 3,000. Check this. 3,000. I wonder if I can add in my, this head cam is pretty weird. 3,000. I'm gonna add in my, let me try and add in my, I'm gonna add in Chrome. It's not working. I won't add in Chrome. So that's what you get there. Pretty sure that's right. Shout out to Keyball 93 here. Shout out to Blue Snowball. It's ASMR. ASMR. We're doing a huge kombucha right now. Here's the world from my perspective. Ain't it cool? Got a bank on this one now. This is one of the first videos of the MOOC. MOOC does every textbook. You can find every question, every textbook. It's the MOOC challenge, yo! It's the MOOC challenge! Okay, on to question 2.3. Sorry if you feel like vomiting. This is episode 1. We're trying to get the kinks out. So, hopefully the volume's adequate. And yeah. Hope so. Okay, 2.3. What principal amount will yield $150 in interest at the end of 3 months when the interest rate is 1% simple interest per month? So, interest equals $150. Time equals 3 months. Interest rate equals 1% per month. So, F minus P equals $150. F equals P times 1 plus I to the N. Which will mean, so we have F in terms of P. So we can find P. We're trying to find P, I believe. We're trying to find the principal amount, so we want to find P. So we can use this equation, to get rid of F. We're trying to find P. So now we have... So this goes to... P... Or no, F... equals... $150 plus P. So there you go. So P plus 150 equals P times 1 plus I to the N is equal to P plus $150 equals P times let's do this. I will take the P away here. And minus the P over here. Tested, we can do F equals P times 1 plus I to the N equals 4950.33 times 1.01 cubed, which should equal this plus 150 exactly, or else God lies, there's no God, everything you know is a lie. 450.33 times 1.01 cubed. So we get 5100.33 exactly, or approximately, but yeah. So that is correct based on all the parameters. So we didn't fuck up the math. It all makes sense. That's how it works. That's unclear. Leave a comment. I can explain it better in its own video. Yeah, the book, by the way, is Global Engineering Economics, 4th edition. Financial Decision Making for Engineers. Niall M. Fraser, Elizabeth M. Dukes, Erwin Bernhardt, and May Tajima. You know, pretty good book, actually. A lot of shit here. The first chapter and the preface were like, just like a quick introduction to the book. Quick definition of like what the book's gonna cover. Maybe I'll like roughly go over it in another video, but yeah, just buy the book. I'll put a link for the book below where you can buy it on Amazon or like a similar book. Anyways, okay, question 2.4. How many is there, by the way? 22. Holy shit. There's 44 questions plus a mini case. This is gonna be like a very long video, like a 4-hour video. I might split it into chunks. Yeah, I might end this here. Okay, that was part one. questions 2.1 to 2.3. I'll try and split into 10-minute chunks. So yeah. Thanks for watching. Hope the headcanon to make you want to throw up. Enjoy the next video.